Welcome to the HETV Game of the Week. I'm Bruce Anderson. We're here at Hoffman Estates High School today, where the Hawks are hosting the Schaumburg Saxons. This is a big game for both of the teams. At 5-2, Hoffman Estates is probably already in the postseason playoffs, but a 6-win would guarantee it and also improve their breck position. It would be the first time in 20 years that Hoffman Estates made the playoffs. Schaumburg, on the other hand, desperately needs another win to have a chance at the playoffs. They started out 4-0, but have now lost their last two games and stand at 4-3. Next week, Schaumburg plays a Palatine team that's currently unbeaten, so a win here tonight is their best hope for getting into the playoffs after losing last week to Frem 21-7. Hoffman Estates will have a tough but winnable game next week at Frem High School after losing a high-fought game last week to the Barrington Broncos 45-41. Hoffman Estates quarterback Austin Coulson has looked very good this year with 17 touchdowns and 1,533 yards. Schaumburg counters with running back Jordan Salgado, who has rushed for 746 yards this season and hopes to take advantage of a Hawk defense that gave up 446 rushing yards to Barrington last week. Last year, Schaumburg won 26-22, but this is a whole new season with very different teams. So stand by for what promises to be an exciting and hard-fought game for the HETV Game of the Week. Stay tuned.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Hoffman Estates High School is proud to present the Hoffman Marching Band, under the field command of drum majors Amanda Batista and Hope Minor. With a rousing rendition of their fight song, we welcome and salute the Saxons from Schaumburg High School. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and join the Hoffman Marching Band in the Hoffman Fight Song! Yeah! remain standing. Gentlemen, please remove your hats and join the Hoffman Marching Band by singing our national anthem under the direction of drum major Amanda Batista.
Field 5-2, having their best season in the last 20 years. The Hawks probably already with a playoff berth for this year with the 5 wins, and it looks like enough points to be in the playoffs. And they're hosting the Schaumburg Saxons, who at 4-3 are scrambling to try to get into the playoffs this year. Schaumburg desperately needs a win here to have any chance at all of getting in the playoffs. Next week they'll be going up against the Palatine Pirates, which up to this week are undefeated along with the Barrington Broncos. Those teams are squaring off today, so only one will remain undefeated at the end of the evening. A beautiful evening for football here. Temperature in the 60s, a near full moon in the sky, very light breeze coming out of the south.
Number 6, Lemire Barnes. Number 17, Eric Delaney. Number 8, Dan Banahan. Number 54, George Morales. Number 43, Jose Abreu. Number 57, Dan Farina. And one of my favorites, number 32, AJ Weeble. Truck is out back in the western part of the parking lot. Pick up a crepe, pick up a donut, some coffee on tonight's crisp night. Maybe a grilled cheese. Support our Hoffman Estates loyal parents. They're also selling gear by the north end zone. We want to welcome our Hoffman Estate Athletic Association Red Hawks, back-to-back national champions. Future Hawks always welcome to Hoffman.
So getting ready for the kickoff here. Hoffman Estates going to be kicking off to Schaumburg. Schaumburg just taking the field, so we'll see the Schaumburg offense first. Be interesting to see what happens. Both teams' offenses do fairly well in the first period and have a bit of a drop off in the second half. But Schaumburg's really tails off, so it'll be interesting to see what happens today. So here we go, the kickoff is up and it's short. comes down at the 35, taken by number 24 and tackled almost immediately. That was Hezekiah Trotter. He got about 2 yards on the return. And Schaumburg is going to put it first and 10 at their own 37-yard line.
I'd also like to welcome assistant golf coach, Hall of Fame human being, Dave Goberic, home on the sidelines. Also want to thank a special guest, the husband of our...
So, number 11, Justin Perez, back ready for the snap. He's rushed pretty well this year, along with Jordan Salgado with almost 750 yards. And there's Salgado up the middle. Looks like he's picked up 4 or 5 yards. We'll have to see where they spot it. Let's call it 5 yards.
We'll be about second and five.
So a good pickup to start off here for Salgado. Hoffman Estates giving up a lot of yardage on the ground last week. There, a handoff to the motion man, number 4, and almost nothing there. Daniel Galovich picked up maybe a yard. Looks like he might have actually lost a yard on that. So 3rd and 6 coming up here.
And emphasis for Dallas Eats supporting the National Honor Society.
Hoffman Estates defense not fooled by that.
Once again, I want to thank iCompete.
So Hoffman Estates looking for a 3 and off. Schaumburg looking for a first down. Fakes a handoff, rolls to his left, puts it up. Over the head, it's intercepted. That's number 27, pulled it down and returned it about 20 yards. Levante Jackson on the INT. So Hoffman Estates gonna be in great field position, 1st and 10 at the Schaumburg 30.
Big shout out to
what a big turn of events as Perez put that over the head of his intended receiver. That picked it off by Levante Jackson. So the Hoffman Estates offense out onto the field.
Jada Coakley going to the sidelines. And Colin at the time.
Justin Perez takes the snap, hands it off up the middle. Oh, running back is buried. He's going to lose a couple yards. That was number 28, Jalen Johnson, going backwards. And Schaumburg was in the backfield on that one, there to meet him as soon as he got the ball. No chance on that one. So 2nd and 12 coming up for Hoffman Estates. So pitch out to Jalen Johnson. And again, not much yardage there. Picked up maybe 2 yards. So 3rd and 11 coming up. Schaumburg defense shutting down the Hoffman Estates offense here so far. Perez has not put it up yet. He's got over 1,500 yards passing so far this season. Oh, and there's an offside. Schaumburg jumped into the neutral zone, 2 of the linemen. So encroachment, that'll be a 5-yard mark off. So it'll be 3rd and 6. That's a much more makeable down and distance. And the Hawks say, thank you, Saxons. So 3rd and 6 coming up. Austin Miller-Colson looking over to the sideline. Hands it off to Johnson, and again, hit almost immediately. Picked up a couple yards maybe, so it's gonna be 4th and about 3. And they're inside the 25, so they're probably in 4 down area here. possible to make a field goal, but looks like they're going to go for it. Two wides to the right, one to the left. Johnson in the backfield. Colson waiting for the snap. Got it. Fakes the handoff. Puts it up. Complete to number two, and he's upended at the five. Jalen Alexander on that reception. So a first down for Hoffman Estates, and they'll have first and goal around the 4 yard line. Nice pitch and catch there for the Hawks. Colson to Alexander. And the Hawks now knocking at the door with a new set of downs. Colson handoff up the middle. Working hard. The feet moving, just can't get there. Short gain. Looks like picked up maybe 2 yards. Ball now on the 2 yard line. Not much room on the ground here so far tonight for the Hawks. They've only got 2 yards to go for pay dirt. Fakes the handoff to his left and just throws it away, and then a head out of bounds. Might be roughing the passer. Yes, it is. That'll be half the distance. That was totally unnecessary. They had that play stopped for no gain. Just a
should be half the distance to the goal.
Late hit there out of bounds. So it gives them another set of downs, first and goal from the one. So Hoffman Estates sitting pretty here. Colson hands it off up the middle, diving in, and touchdown! So that number 28, Jalen Johnson, in for the touchdown. So Hoffman Estates draws first blood here. 7:20 left to go in the first quarter. Hoffman Estates up 6-0 pending the extra point. And the kick is up, and it's good. So Hoffman Estates takes the 7-0 lead. And that started off by a Clavante Jackson interception. So the Hawks cash in on the turnover. So Schaumburg gonna have to get something going here.
Once again, we have the Full Moon Friday Night Food Truck Bonanza going out back. Dardo Zuru, you got something already for dinner. Grab yourself a grilled cheese, some coffee and donuts. Buy something for the kids who might compete at Hoffman Estates Athletic Association. Mike Rivera, get your money out. Go buy the kids some coffee.
Getting ready for the kickoff. Waiting for the ball, it gets thrown in. Connor Langor getting ready to kick off. Connor Langor, 5'11", 175-pound junior, starts forward. The kick is up. Another pooch kick taken about the 25. And a nice hole there off the right side. That's number 24, Travon Hall. Or, I'm number 24, Hezekiah Trotter. Big hole off the right side, gets it out to about the 40-yard line. So the Saxons take over with pretty good field position, 40 yards to go for a tying touchdown. Not able to move the ball very much at all on their first possession. We'll see what they can do here. Two wides to the left, one to the right. Perez takes it, hands it off the left side. They've got a nice hole there. Pickup of about eight for Salgado. Looks like they're going to give him seven on that. So a nice hole there.
About six for the second and four. Please support our National Honor Society's fight against breast cancer.
They're going to give him six. Second and four coming up here.
Santa Lucia for me.
A little extra motion on that. Not trying to pull it right up the middle. Find a nice hole off the right side. Again, two wides left, one to the right. Two backs in the backfield. Again, Salgado off the middle. Bounces off the pile. Spins forward for a first down. So the Hawk defense not wrapping him up, just trying to knock him down, and he was able to spin away and pick up the first down. So first and 10 from the 28. 6:20 left in the first quarter. Perez barking out the signals. Trips to the right. And Jordan Salgado knocked down immediately. May have lost a yard on that one. They had three blockers out in front of him. Just nowhere to go. Hoffman Estates sniffed that out immediately. So second and 11 coming up here.
Well, congratulations on the principal, Mr. Shoemaker.
Surprised at the light turnout by Schaumburg. Only about half the bleachers full across the field. Perez rolling to his left, fakes the pass, pulls it down around the left side. Good gain, picked up about 10. And we saw last week, Perez, even though he's rolling out, doesn't mean he's going to pass it. He's got a lot of yardage this year on the ground. There's an injury timeout. That was Perez that was shaken up.
Are selling Hoffman gear to the offensive in the shed.
Slow to get up, goes over to the sideline.
Back here in the parking lot. Pick yourself up some coffee, some donuts. Mr. Wallace, Professor, pick up the coffee.
So third and two coming up. Perez may have to sit out a play because of that injury timeout.
Host of other Hawks tonight, the class of 86 and 76.
So number 13, Kevin Kapinski, coming into the game.
Welcome back, Chairman.
And Cameron Powell in at quarterback, number 7. And there's a flag. Delay of game against Schaumburg. A lot of motion, some confusion with a new quarterback in there. That's going to cost him 5.
It's a 5-yard penalty. Make it third and. Make it third and.
So third and 7 coming up. Like Perez back into the game for this snap. Hand off up the middle. Out to about the 30-yard line.
Salgado, just about to the 20.
Going to be fourth and two.
Two and a half.
So looks like more like fourth and three.
Three.
But they're
fourth
on the 20-yard line. They're going to go for it here. Waiting the snap, takes it, he's rolling to his right, puts it up, complete, oh, and that's dropped off the hands of Jacob Bishop. Bishop had it, tried to run before he had it, and lost the handle, so the ball will go over on downs. Bishop, a junior, should know better than that. So 3:46 to play. Hoffman Estates going to take over. They'll have the ball on their own 20. Okay, Colson waiting for the snap, has three wides to the right, hands it off up the middle. Short gain,
Johnson on the carry.
Maybe 2 yards by Johnson.
Pick up a two on the play, will be second and eight. Big shout out to Angel Beltran, continuing to work on the sideline.
So both teams continuing to try up the middle, not much there so far this evening. Looking to the sideline, has three receivers to the left, one to the right. Johnson in the backfield. Fakes to the motion man, complete to number nine
to Finalade.
So Hoffman Estates pick up the first down through the air.
16 yards.
That pitch and catch good for 16 yards and a new set of downs.
Shout out to Nate Fisher for the good game.
Again, three wides to the left, one to the right. Fakes to both motion men, rolling to the right, kind of a shot put out to Finalade, but ugly looking shovel pass and complete, second and 10 coming up. Colson under pressure there, just got rid of that ball. 2:41 left in the first quarter. Hoffman Estates moving the ball here well so far in the first quarter. That ball complete out to the sideline to number 80, Daniel Banahan. Close to a first down. We'll see where they mark it. And it is a first down.
It's good enough for a Hawk. First down.
So the Hawks moving well through the air, as you would expect for Hawks. Again, three wides to the left. Kind of a wishbone formation by the receivers. Johnson in the backfield. Hands off to Johnson.
Jalen Johnson picks up about four.
Right guard picks up, looks like about 4 yards. So a nice run there by Johnson. Takes the handoff and under pressure. Got to get outside the hash. Puts it up. And that was in the area of Jalen Johnson. But Colson waiting a long time to get rid of that ball, trying to make something out of nothing, not able to. So third and six coming up here. Two wides to each side. Johnson in the backfield. Oh, ball tipped at the line of scrimmage. It will fall incomplete. 98, Tyler Fredrickson, the defensive lineman, able to get a paw up and knock that down. Fredrickson, a 6'2", 215-pound senior. And it looks like the Hawks are going to go for it. So the ball on their own 47. Maybe seeing if they can draw Schaumburg off sides. We'll see. Nope, there's the snap. Quick kick. And that hits at the 15, takes a Hoffman bounce. And that's down at the 1 yard line. Beautifully executed. Quick kick that pins him way back the inside the 1 yard line. So Schaumburg gonna have to go the length of the field if they're gonna score this time, sports fans. They've got their work cut out for them. So I would expect them to run it here. Maybe a quarterback keeper, but they've got very little room to operate. Perez takes it, hands it off up the middle to Salgado, bounces off the pile again, has room off the left side. It pushed out around the 10, a pickup of about 9. So again, a big bunch in there in the middle, and Salgado able to bounce off and pick up significant yardage around the outside. So second and one coming up. A lot better position now. They have some breathing room. Salgado gets it again up the middle. Out to about the 15-yard line. That's good enough for a first down.
Good enough for a Saxon first down. Talking about A.J. Weeble.
So Schaumburg with a new set of downs. Ball out to the 17-yard line.
An
inside 1 minute here to go in the first period. Two wide to the left, one to the right. Salgado gets it off the right side. This time not nearly as much. Pickup of about 2 or 3 yards.
Also want to say
hi to Trayvon Hall on the tackle there. Looks like they're going to give him about 3 yards on that one. So second and 7 coming up. Wind picking up a little bit here. Gusting out of the south. Three wides to the left, one to the right. Salgado has it again. Off right tackle, picked up about 5 yards, out to about the 26-yard line maybe. So about third and one coming up here. And that was the last play of the first quarter. The teams will turn around and head the other direction. The score, Hoffman Estates 7, Schaumburg nothing. Thank you. Okay, getting ready here to start the second quarter. Schaumburg, third and two. Salgado takes it around the left side. He's got an opening and a first down out to about the 30-yard line. So Schaumburg having good luck here moving the ball. Two first downs in a row. This drive started at their 1-yard line and they're out to the 30. Two backs in the backfield, two wides, hands it off to Salgado again, trying the left side again, able to break a tackle. Carries a couple of tacklers with him. Good enough for the first down, but there is a flag on the play. See what the call is.
Many chances to sell in bracelets and necklaces.
Holding by Schaumburg, that'll set him back. Wipes out the first down.
Against Schaumburg.
Cost them 10 yards.
Looks like the grilled cheese is shut down for the night. But the donuts and coffee and crepes are still available. So I'm going to pick up Mr. Harlan a coffee.
So instead of another first and 10, it's going to be first and 20.
First and 19 from the 21-yard line. Malik, world history homework.
So two receivers out to each side. Gives it to the motion man, number one around the right side. He's got a few.
Carry Ferguson on the carry.
Ferguson.
Tackled by Trayvon Hall.
Picked up about 6 yards there. So number one, Dakari Ferguson, the motion man. Around the right side. It's about 5 of those yards back. Second to 14 coming up. Gives it to Salgado off the right side, able to break a tackle. Picks up about 4 yards. So that'll bring up a third and about 9.
Third and 9 for the Saxons.
So 2 carries for 9 yards. With the penalty, they still have 9 more yards to go. 10 minutes left in the first half. Fake, Salgado. Perez, oh, he's tackled. He's creamed back at the 25-yard line. Perez faked the handoff and was level. So a loss of about 6 on the play. That'll bring up 4th and about 15. So Schaumburg going to punt it away.
Back to punt, back to receive.
So Schaumburg had a couple first downs and then that holding penalty set him back and killed the drive. So Jalen Alexander waiting for the punt, standing back on his own 30. There's the snap and the kick, and it's short. Bounces to Alexander at the 30 and hit about the 40, and he's swarmed under by 8 or 10 of the Saxons there. Just nowhere to go, but a good job of getting that bouncing ball. Probably saved him another 10 or 15 yards and a little scuffle breaking out there after the play. So Alexander pushed way back after fielding that bouncing ball. And the Hawks will put it in play, first and 10 from their own 25.
special guest appearance tonight by Mr. Chuck Abbott, Rock himself.
So, fakes the handoff and a little swing pass out there, dropped by the intended receiver.
Incomplete passes.
That was to Javon Blissett, not able to bring that one down. Might have heard footsteps. So that'll bring up second and 10. Three receivers to the left, one to right. Johnson takes the pitch and he's going to lose yardage.
Johnson in the backfield.
Schaumburg playing in the black backfield. There to bury Johnson as soon as he got the ball, a loss of five on that play. So Hoffman Estates going in reverse on this drive, third and 15. Wilson's got the snap, looking left, puts it up. Got it complete. Able to break some tackles. Jalen Alexander picks up the first down, cutting all the way across the field. Nice play, first down Hawks. Ball at the 39-yard line. Fakes a handoff, swings it out. And Jalen Alexander again fumbles the ball. Let's see who's got it. Schaumburg says it's them. No official word yet. And Hoffman retains possession. Schaumburg really sure they had it. But no, possession retained by the Hawks. The Schaumburg coach not happy with that call at all. So Hoffman Estates lucky on that. They only had one man out there, Jalen Alexander, who caught that ball in about three Saxons. But Alexander able to fall back on that ball for no gain. Hawks retain possession. Clock continues to run on the fumble. And a timeout call.
There's a timeout.
Hoffman Estates gonna talk things over.
Good time to remind everyone about the food trucks out back and the rest down to the Garber Stadium. Also, NHS is selling bracelets and wristbands for adults to support breast cancer awareness. Hoffman Estates Little Parents are also selling your Hawk gear, orange and blue, and North End Zone Shed.
Okay, so Hoffman Estates back out onto the field. Been moving the ball well through the air, running it enough to keep the defense honest. Most of their games been through the air here tonight. Second and 10. Two wideouts to the right, one to the left. Johnson in the backfield. Low snap, picked up by Colson. Hands it to Johnson, able to stay in bounds, just tippy-toe around the sidelines, and he's knocked out about the 45. There's a flag. It's like holding against the Hawks. It is holding against the Hawks, so that'll cost him 10.
You can hear
So second and 18 coming up. So trips right, one wide to the left. Johnson in the backfield. Johnson goes in motion. He's out in the flat, receives the pass, and he's tackled immediately. And then another flag.
Johnson's pass is complete, tackled immediately by number one. There's a flag on the play. And a Ferguson on the tackle.
Another hold by the Hawks. So pass to Johnson out in the flat. Stop for no gain, but the hold, that'll take him back another 10 yards from the spot of the foul. Holding was declined by Schaumburg. They'll So that'll bring up third down. No gain on that play. Maybe even a loss of one. So Schaumburg elects to take the play and the down. Olson hands it off, draw play. Gonna pick up a little. Oh, there's the ball out. Caught in the air by a Hawk. Number 58, Brandon Shepherd, the lineman, caught that ball on the fly, maintained possession, be fourth down and nine. So Hoffman Estates going to punt it away here. There, the ball's away. Hezekiah Trotter takes it on the bounce, fakes the handoff, but keeps it, and he's knocked down around the 30. So, a few yards there for Trotter. Out to the 29-yard line. The Saxons will put it in play. So both teams having penalties, killing their last drives. Pass, good for about 9 yards. Close to a first down, we'll see where they mark it.
Trotter on the catch, tackle number 13, Sean Brown. Good enough for a Saxon first down.
And that reception by Trotter, good enough for a first down. And a Hawk down on the field in Chihawk. Looks like Sean Brown.
Number 13, Sean Brown.
Linebacker.
Another round of applause for Sean Brown. The first and 10. The Saxons at the 39-yard line.
So Sean Brown able to walk off under his own power. That's good to see. Schaumburg will have it, first and 10, the 39-yard line. 5:04 left to play in the first half. Perez hands it off. Looked like he had a bigger hole.
Salgado tripped up by A.J.
Salgado brought down by A.J. Weeble, able to reach up and grab an ankle after a gain of 9. So Schaumburg moving well again on this drive.
AP USS students, Julia Harris.
Two receivers to each side. So got on the backfield. And Perez is going to keep it off the right side. He's gotten up for the first down.
Justin Perez dives forward for a first down.
So across midfield to about the 48-yard line. A new set of downs for Schaumburg. So Schaumburg moving the sticks. Clock also running. 4 minutes left here. Two wides to the left, one to the right, two backs in the backfield. Perez takes it, hands it off up the middle. The number four skirts around the right side, spun to the ground. Galovich on the carry. Tackled by Weevil, about 2 yards, yard and a half. So we'll call it second and eight coming up. Oh, a handoff to number four around the left side. He's got it. Oh, brought down by a shirt tail at the 25. Dante Galovich, or Daniel Galovich, rather, for another first down. Big yardage off the left side. So a new set of downs, ball at the 23 and a half yard line, 3:10 left in the first half. Schaumburg moving well here. Perez hands it off to Trotter. Takes a big hit about the 15. We'll see where they mark it.
Picks up about 8.
So second and two coming up. Actually, it looks like a gain of about 9. Second and one coming up. So good gains around the edges. Not much up the middle here so far tonight. Off to the motion man, number 24, and he's in. Hezekiah Trotter around the left side in the pay dirt. So with 2:14, score 7-6 pending the extra point. Hoffman Estates had set the Saxons down here tonight, but nice drive down the field. And here, trying to tie it up, Mason Laramie. The kick is up, and it's good. So 7-7 the score with 2:14 left in the first half. The Saxons on the drive before that looking good until a penalty set them back. Able to drive the field and tie the game up. Laramie moves forward, puts the ball up. It's a deep kickoff this time, taking about the 5. It's Ty Grace. And he's nailed at about the 13-yard line.
Number 69, Don Smith on the tackle.
Well, the Schaumburg side appreciating that hit. Grace just landed. So the Hawks going to start off on their 14-yard line. The game now tied. There's a completed pass. out across the 30-yard line.
Tulsi's pass, good.
That was Finolade. He's been seeing a lot of action today. 6'1", 180-pound senior. So first and 10 from the 33. Again, back to pass. Again, out to Alade. And he's behind the defense. He could go. And he does. Touchdown, Alade. I'm sorry, that's Javon Blissett. Blissett on the touchdown. 6'2", 190-pound junior scores in a hurry.
67-yard pass play from Tulsa to Blissett. Lankor for the point after 10.
60 yards. The Hawks able to score quickly. The kick is up. And it's good. So just like that, 14-7 Hawks. So the Hoffman offense wasting no time and putting up another score. Connor Lankor going to kick it off here. And it's up, kicks it deep. Taken back at the 9-yard line. That's Dakari Ferguson. Out across the 30 to about the 34-yard line. So good return there by Ferguson. Schaumburg will have it in good position at the 34-yard line. But only a minute 33 to move the ball.
Big shout to Mr. Mitchie. Worried about him after the Hawks lost on Wednesday night.
So Schaumburg got to go into the hurry up offense here. Hands it to the motion man, number 24, around the right side, and he's picking up maybe a yard. That's Hezekiah Trotter.
NHS still selling bracelets, still selling necklaces for a dollar. Santa, send me for me, please. Support breast cancer awareness and research.
So, second and 9, the clock continues to run. Perez back to pass, puts it up. Out too far for Trotter again.
He's
not able to catch up with that one. Kind of a low pass and out in front of him. Stops the clock with a minute and 1 second left. So third and 8 coming up.
Did a great job with homecoming last week.
Two wides each side for Schaumburg. Quick pitch and catch.
Screen pass is
out to number 5, Duke Gray. And it looks like he's got enough for a first down. It's going to be close. We'll have to see where they mark it.
And very short. 55 seconds.
Looks like he's just short. Fourth and about a half a yard.
Proper states, but not a good weightlifter.
So Schaumburg going to go for it, 54.2 seconds. Fourth and a short one. Maybe trying to get a false start by Hoffman Estates here. Looks like that's what they're doing. Yep, and they call a timeout.
The field.
The Hawks very disciplined, not going to jump on that.
What do you want, Sam?
So we'll see what they do after they talk it over. A little bit of a risk going for it on your side of the 50-yard line. And it didn't take Hoffman Estates long to score on their last possession, so they might be able to get points if they turn it over here. So Schaumburg back out. Looks like they're going to go for it. Possible. Up the middle, oh, I don't know. They're still grinding it out. Looks like he got it on second effort.
Jordan Salgado.
Salgado up the middle.
Number 57.
Picks up about a yard. Only needed a half a yard, so that'll move the chains. Clock running inside 50 seconds here. Short snap, pitch and catch out to the right side. That's Duke Gray again. Out of bounds, stops the clock with 42.8 seconds. Ball just inside the 50-yard line at the Schaumburg 49. Justin Perez able to put it up. Haven't seen it very much here tonight. Three backs in the backfield. Perez keeper rolling right. And he's going to be tackled for a loss. Loss of about five, and the clock's still running. So third and 10 coming up.
Number 17, Eric Delaney for the Hawks. Loss of
25 seconds left in the first half. Maybe one more play here. Looks like they may just let the time expire. Help to get the snap off. Rolling right, gonna keep it. And out of bounds as time expires. Justin Perez, not able to advance the ball. So, at a halftime, Hoffman Estates Hawks 14, Schaumburg Saxons 7. We'll be back after halftime.
Maybe a few jokes of Mr. Figler.
Jason.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Hoffman Estates High School is again proud to present the Hoffman Marching Band. Under the field command of drum majors Holt Minor and Amanda Batista. Tonight, we are honoring our senior band and flag corps members who are performing in the last regular season football game. We know our seniors are already considering what road they will be traveling as they search for their personal goals and meaning of life in their own land of Oz.
Okay, we're back to start the second half. Schaumburg getting ready to kick it off. At the beginning of the game, I thought it was quite classy of the Hoffman Estates band to play the Schaumburg fight song before playing the Hoffman Estates fight song to welcome the Schaumburg students here to Hoffman Estates High School. I appreciated that. So the Saxons trailing by 7, gonna kick it off here. The kick is up and it's deep and it's out of the end zone for a touchback. So Hoffman Estates will start at their own 20-yard line. So Hoffman Estates with touchdowns by Javon Blissett and also Jalen Johnson, and Schaumburg scoring by Hezekiah Trotter. So two more periods to go. This game hard fought like we thought it might be. The Schaumburg offense has not done much this year in the second half. We'll have to see what happens here. So Colson back waiting for the snap, takes it, hands it off up the middle. Oh, it's a keeper able to duck out from under a tackle and throws that ball away. Nice fake on the handoff, but didn't fool Schaumburg. Had to throw it away to avoid the sack.
Jennifer Banahan is incomplete. We have 2nd and 10. Once again, if you're driving a Civic behind the Civic, License plate 882-9319. You're blocking the buses. Taylor, is that your car? No? It's off of you. Please remove it. Please move your car.
Hey, here's a snap. Hand off up the middle, going nowhere. Might have even lost a yard on that.
Number 98, Fredrickson, and number 8, without the tone.
Johnson just finding no running room up the middle. Luton says a yard, that'll bring up 3rd and 11. Schaumburg defense looking stout here to start off the second half. The Hawks doing a lot of their damage through the air in the first half. Two wide to the left, one to the right. Johnson in the backfield. Colson out to the left. Has to throw it away. Out of bounds, caught nicely by a Schaumburg coach. But that'll bring a 4th and 11. So Hoffman going to have to punt here. So a good stand by the Schaumburg D, forcing a 3 and out. Schaumburg should get the ball back in good field position to start the second half. There's the kick, kind of a side foot kick. Caught at the 50 and then brought down at the 45. Just not much room there for Hezekiah Trotter. Able to fall forward and pick up a couple yards. But Schaumburg going to take over on the Hawk 45-yard line. The Hawks with a short field to start the second half. Justin Perez and company out onto the field. Two wides each side. And Salgado in the background. A handoff to the motion man, reverses his field. Got a first down and may go all the way. He does. Touchdown, Dakari Ferguson in for the score, but there is a flag down on the play. Ferguson started right, swung it back around left.
Penalty is holding.
Holding against Schaumburg. Oh, that's a costly penalty. That takes the touchdown off the boards, and it'll cost them 10 yards besides. So the penalty from the spot of the foul. First and
food
8.
Food truck is still open. Full moon Friday night, food truck is open. Crabs are still being
There's
sold.
There's still a gain of 2 after that penalty.
The west side of Gary's Stadium.
And off to Salgado around the right side. Picks up about 3 yards out to the 40-yard line.
Picked up a few yards, it'll be 2nd and 5 for the Saxons. Big shout out to Emma Ludek, working the sidelines.
So 3 wide to the left, 1 to the right. Salgado fakes taking the handoff.
Trotter
out close to a first down. He's down around the 35. We'll have to see where they mark it. Looks like he's just short. About the length of a football. So 3rd and a short one. Salgado takes it around the right side, able to spin and pick up about 2 more yards. On a first down, new set of moves the chains. Schaumburg able to keep the drive alive.
Kara Jones is going to save somebody.
takes a low snap, swings the ball out into the flat. Complete.
Pass is complete. Press pass is complete to Duke Gray.
That was out to Duke Gray, who was able to break a couple tackles. Picked up about 7 yards on the play. Second and three coming up. So Schaumburg having good luck here in the second half. Or maybe it's just good execution. Two wides each side. Motion man number four around the right side. He's going to be short. Daniel Galovich.
Galovich hit by Tyler Fox. NHS is still selling $1 wristbands and necklaces in support of breast cancer.
So third and two coming up here.
Does it help find a cure? $1 for a necklace, $1 for a bracelet.
Salgado takes it up the middle. He's still on his feet, breaking tackles left and right down to about the 15-yard line.
Number 28, Jordan Salgado is good enough for a
Looks like they're going to mark it on the 16. Nice run by Salgado for the first down. So Schaumburg moving nicely. Again, to Salgado up the middle.
Salgado up the middle again, picks up about 5.
Good pickup, about 5 yards. So first half, there was nothing up the middle, and they're able to pick up some good yardage here in the second half. There's 7 minutes left here in the third quarter. And off to the motion man, that's Salgado. Able to break a couple tackles.
24 on the carry.
Got up to about the 10-yard line.
Tackled by number 44.
That was Trotter on the carry, rather. Inside the 10 to about the 9, so third and 2 coming up here. So two backs in the backfield with Perez. Hands it off. Oh, fumbled handoff.
Quick fumble, so but recovered by number 11, Justin Perez.
They lost about 3 on
that. A couple yards.
So about fourth and 5.
Six.
So it looks like Schaumburg's going to try for a field goal here.
Mason Larrabee
stepping it off. And timeout called. Schaumburg coach not happy over on the sideline. Running out, yelling at his team, calling timeout. We'll see if they're going to change what they're going to do here. Looks like the tee is being set up a little farther back this time than it was last time. That may have been the problem. So Laramie going going to try for the three. There's the snap. The kick is blocked. And the holder number two, Austin Elzamo, able to fall on that ball. But the Hawks stuffed the field goal attempt. And as a result, they get the ball at their own 31.5-yard line.
That's a blocked field goal by our 27, Clavante Jackson.
Points off the board. Clavante Jackson able to get in and block that kick. So after a nice drive here by Schaumburg, they come up empty. And the Hawks get the ball in decent field position on their own 31. So Colson with three wide receivers to the right. Looking right, there is a flag. And pass is complete to Javon Blissett. Hoffman Estates holding on that one. It's going to bring that back. Blissett had a first down and more, but all for naught after the hold.
First and 26.
So that's a 10-yard walk-off from the spot of the foul. Makes it first and 26.
Come on, Hoffman! So
the ball on the 16-yard line. Three wide to the left, two to the right. Colson looks to the sideline for the play. He's rolling, he throws that away over the head of his wide receiver number 80, Daniel Banahan. But Colson again running for his life in the backfield as he was being chased by a couple Saxons. So second and 26 coming up. So trips white, single wide to the left. Colson rolling to his right, puts it up. Oh, that knocked away, tipped by the defense. I think number four, Daniel Galevich, getting a hand on it.
Incomplete pass as they call the officials. We'll bring up third down. 26.
So some contact there on the Hoffman receiver, but that was after the ball had been tipped by the Saxon defender.
Official's timeout for
injury. Got a official's timeout. An injured player there on the sidelines. Been a lot of the injured Hawk on that play. Walking a bit gingerly, it's Still 3rd and 26. A long, long way to go on that. Schaumburg playing two deep safeties. A little swing pass. Oh, able to break a tackle. And out for the first down. Unbelievable. Terrible tackling by Schaumburg. But Jalen Johnson able to take that little swing pass and got out just short of the 50-yard line. Hawks with a new set of downs at the 48. Johnson able to break a couple tackles there on the way. So the momentum now switching over to Hoffman Estates. Big play there. Counter play is snuffed out and dropped for a loss.
Two of the Saxons, Austin and Zelmo. It's a loss of two and a half. It'll be second and 12.
And Zelmo dropping Michael Eppenbaugh for a loss. Eppenbaugh, a small back, 5'7", 145. It's a junior. So second and 12 coming up here. And timeout called. Colson seeing something he didn't like. Tees it up, calls timeout. 3:50 left in the third period. Hawks leading 14-7. Okay, second and 12. Colson looking it over. Pitches it out to number two, Jalen Alexander, and he's still on his feet. Broke a couple tackles, and he's down to the 35 of Schaumburg. Just shredded that defense. Jalen Alexander just leaving Schaumburg defenders in his wake, able to move the chains. So the Hoffman offense back in gear and they're moving it here. First and 10 from the 34. Olsen hands it off to the motion man, 24. Again, Trevon Hall around the right side. Nice gain, we'll see where they mark it.
Austin Carlson.
Looks like about a 6-yard gain there.
Second and three. Food truck's still open. Line is still steady. About 7 or 8 people.
Down to the 27-yard line. Clock continuing to run at 2:50. Again, handed off. Trevon Hall just breaking tackles right and left. My goodness. Finally forced out about the 4-yard line. What a run by Trevon Hall. And Hoffman Estates knocking on the door. Ball is spotted at the 5-yard line, first and goal. 2:41 left in the third quarter. Hawks looking to the sideline for the play. Colson brings a man in motion. Hand off to number 12 off the left side. keeps touchdown! His feet moving at ease, and Ty Grayson for the touchdown. So the Hawks up 20-7, pending the extra point. So the kick is up and it's good. So 21-7. Hoffman Estates Hawks jump up by two TDs. Able to turn that one around. Schaumburg had driven down, was in field goal range. The Hawks stuff it and then take it back the other way for seven. Okay, here comes the kick, and it's an onside kick. How about that? And the ball's still bouncing around, and Hoffman Estates has it. Hoffman Estates doing the onside kick, up by two touchdowns, and they recover it. That ball batted around, popping around like a pinball. And one of the Hawk linemen able to fall on that. And they'll take over at midfield. So talk about taking the wind out of the Saxon sails. Hoffman Estates with a trick onside kick when nobody expected it. .227 left in the third period. So Colson and company back in business. Fakes the handoff. He's gonna scramble to his right. Goes out of bounds about the 45-yard line. Pick up about 5 yard line. Making something out of nothing there. So second and 5 coming up here.
Second and 5, food trucks are still open. There is no line right now at the coffee and donut food truck.
So Colson with 3 wides to the left, 2 to the right, empty backfield. Michael Eppenbaum falls back. And then takes the handoff, and he's going to lose about 3 yards.
Tyler Fredrickson, also a couple yards.
Eppenbaum motioned back into the backfield to take that handoff and lost 3 yards. 2 minutes left in the third period. The Hawks up by 14 points, 21-7. So a handoff around the right side.
Trayvon Hall muscles a couple yards out of it.
Hall around the right side, bounced off the first couple tacklers, not able to shed enough of them for much of a gain. Picks up about 2, bring up about 4th and 6 from the 46-yard line. Hoffman offense They're out there. Looks like they're going to go for it. Could also be a quick kick. Trying to draw him offside. Schaumburg not buying it. And they are going to kick it away. Colson kicks it, taken at the 16-yard line. That's number four, Denny Galovich, and he's just planted.
One last tackle by number two, Jalen Alexander.
Jalen Alexander on the tackle. Schaumburg will take over on their own 20. 39.7 left to play here in the third quarter. Hoffman Estates up 21-7. So Perez and the Saxons need to get something going here, gain some ground. Hands it off to the motion man. That's Dakari Ferguson, and he had the... Looks like he lost a couple on that one.
Lost him a couple on that one. It'll be second and 12 for the Saxons with 32.6 seconds left. Jenny Neverett looking nice and warm and toasty. Get some coffee. What's up?
Cheap. So two wides each side. Low snap. Perez going to his right, and he's going to be tackled for a loss. Down about the 12-yard line. Schaumburg drive going backwards.
It's got to make Coach Murch happy.
So third and 17 coming up. Hoffman Estates defense just having their way with the Saxons right now as time's about to expire. And there it is, that's the end of the third period with the Hawks leading 21-7.
Because they're so nice, why not twice?
Okay, so we've switched sides. Still third and 17. Perez rolling to his right, and he throws that away.
Nice coverage by number seven, Andrew Jones.
There's nowhere to go with that ball. So Jimmy Burks applying the pressure, making Perez throw that ball away. So the Saxons getting ready to punt here. Hawks should get the ball in good field position. There's a kick up and it's short. It hits around the 40-yard line, takes a little bit of a Schaumburg roll. That's gonna roll dead around the 49. So the Hawks with a short field, 49 yards to go for another score.
Food truck still open if you're chilly. We'll hot chocolate, a little coffee.
So we're 19 seconds into the fourth quarter, 11:41 to go. And Hoffman Estates in great shape here. So the season pattern holding true. Schaumburg just not able to get much going here in the second half. So Colson and company, and off to number 25 around the left side, and there's a flag taken out of bounds around the 35. That was Eppenbaugh on the carry. But holding against the Hawks, that's going to bring it back and then some. So about first and 15 after the hold. Back to the line of scrimmage, three wide receivers to the right. Fakes it to the motion man. Up the middle, number 38, Jalen Johnson. Nowhere to go, maybe a yard.
No gain on the play, we remain second down with 15 yards to go.
Justin Elzomo on the tackle. Clock continuing to run. The clock is Hoffman's friend right now. Pulls it back. Swings that out to number 20, and he's going to be tackled for no gain. Sorry, that was 28 Johnson that was tackled on that. So the clock continuing to run down to 10 minutes. Two wides right, one to the left. Swing pass out to Johnson again. Got ahead of steam. Oh, and he's taken down by the ankle there. Austin Elzomo again on the tackle. But fourth and five coming up. Johnson able to find a hole there. Nice pickup. Often made. Try to get the Hawks off, the Saxons off sides here. Needing 5 yards. There's a snap, quick kick. Takes a Hawk roll. And down right about the goal line. So that ball down about the half-yard line.
Receiving a touchback around the 1 yard line. After a nice play close.
So Colson with the quick kick. So the ball down on the 1 yard line. The Saxons gonna have to go 99 yards if they're gonna score here. Hand off up the middle, looking for a little bit of running room. That's Salgado
tripped up by Liberty Barnes.
Looks like he picked up about a about 3 yards there. Second and seven. Perez puts it up. No, through the hands of the intended receiver there, number 14. Jacob Bishop not able to haul that one in. So third and seven coming up. Perez keeping it. Rowland gets it out. Off the hand of number 24, Hezekiah Trotter, not able to bring that one in. So Schaumburg going to have to punt here. The punter going to be after. Be careful not to step out of the back of the end zone on this when he takes a snap. So there's a kick. It's short kick. Hits about the 25, goes sideways. Then hit by a Saxons. So looks like they're going to mark it about the 27. So Hoffman Estates with a short field. So Hoffman Estates ready to put it in play here. Hands it off to the motion man. That's number 24, Eppenbaugh.
Nice strong run by Trayvon Hall. Tackled by number four.
Sorry, 24, Trayvon Hall. And an injury on the field. Number 26, Victor Olitian. Down for the Saxons. And a pickup of about five on that play.
Coach Cleveland, I'm still waiting on my chicken ball here.
So Victor Olaton hobbling off under his own power. Good to see him not needing any help.
Second
and five coming up here. Hoffman Estates on the 22-yard line. Colson repositioning his men. Fakes the handoff to the motion man up the middle. Big gain. First down for Jalen Johnson. So, first and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Two wides to the right, one to the left. Johnson up the middle, not much there.
Run by Johnson. Into some Saxons.
Looks like he got back to the line of scrimmage, but nothing more. That'll bring up second and 10. Clock continuing to run at 6:50 left in the game. Olson takes a snap, looking right, puts it up in the corner. Touchdown! Complete to Javon Blissett. His second touchdown of the day. So 27-7, the Hawks up by 20 points, pending the extra point after attempt. Kick is up and it's good. So 28-7. The Hoffman Estates Hawks getting ready to go 6-2 here on the season, getting ready for postseason play for the first time in 20 years. Looking very good tonight against Schaumburg. Schaumburg losing 21-7 last week. Trailing 28-7 here. Open up the champagne pocket. It's my house, come on, turn it up. Hear a knock on the door and the night begins. Cause we've done this before, so you come on in. So Connor Lancor getting ready to kick it off here. 6:31 left in the game. Another onside kick, that's not going to go 10 yards. Out of bounds at the 49-yard line. So Schaumburg with a short field. They'll take over possession on the Hoffman Estates 49-yard line. Hoffman Estates trying another onside kick. Can't get that one to go 10 yards. Okay, the Saxons got to get something going here. Been shut out here in the second half. Tries the middle again. Salgado got nowhere to go. Looks like he might have lost a half yard. The center of that Hawk line solid. So loss of about a yard on the play. Perez rolling to his left, throws complete for maybe a yard.
Pass completed to Deontay Arnold. Moved by the Kettle Hawks.
Deontay Arnold catches that one. Back to the original line of scrimmage. So third and 10 coming up, the clock still running. 5:30 left to play here in the game. Two wides each side, looking left. Again, throws it short, complete to number nine. He picks up about five, Alexander Burke. But a flag on the play.
Sean Brown on the tackle for the Hawks. I want to thank all the members of I Compete and Hoffman Estates.
Looks like a face mask against the Hawks. That should give him a first down.
It's a face mask.
So first down by penalty.
Giacomo Hensley in the house. We have your ID in the press box. Do not know how it got here. So we do have your ID. You might need it.
So first and 10, Perez going to keep it up the middle and maybe a yard. Not much there.
It's a run by number 11, Justin Perez. Tackle by Lamir Barnes.
Perez usually does better when he tries to go around the outside. Nothing there up the middle. 4:50 left to play. 28-7, Hawks lead.
Shut down, I think. Nope, crates are still up. Still grab yourself a crate. Support our general club too on the way there and get a breath.
So Perez back waiting the snap. Looking left, puts it up. Short. Bounced that ball into number 9, Alexander Burke. So third and 10. Got that first down by penalty and haven't been able to do a thing with it since. Perez back, looking over the field. He's putting it up deep. That's over everybody's head. The only one there with a chance to catch it, Mashawn Bradford for the Hawks.
I got it.
And that was over his head as well.
Pass was intended to number 6, Dante Arnold, coverage by number 21, Mashawn Bradford, the senior. Fourth down and long for the Saxons. Big shout out to the East Coast connection, Taylor and Byron.
So on 4th and 10, the Saxons going to go for it. They're trailing by 3 scores. Perez rolling to his right, under pressure, and he's going to be sacked. Hit hard and down about the 48-yard line. So they're going to turn it over on downs. So Schaumburg just not able to get anything going here in the second half. So Schaumburg about ready, or Hoffman Estates ready to put it in play just outside the Schaumburg side of the field. Number 12 around the right side for a first down. That's Ty Grace. Picking up about 12 yards on the carry, sweeping the right side.
Number 12, Ty Grace.
Moving the chains.
On the scamper, good enough for a Hawk. First down. This game tonight sponsored by Mr. Figler's bowling team. Asking to support his bowlers this coming winter. Many girls interested trying out.
So quarterback keeper around the right side, Coulson into the backfield,
take
across the 20-yard line.
First down.
Could have had 2 first downs on that one. Nice pickup by Coulson. Haven't seen him run it in a while. So first and 10 from the 20-yard line. Hawks got another fine drive going here. 3:40 left in the game. And off up the middle to number 12. That's Ty Grace on the carry. Looks like he picked up about 5 yards. So second and 5, up the middle. Ty Grace again.
Oh, that's run by Ty Grace.
First down, it'll be first and goal to go from about the 4-yard line.
That one is good enough for Hawk. First down.
So Hoffman Estates knocking on the door again. chance to extend the lead here. Already up 28-7. Ball in the red zone. Coulson looking the defense over, takes a snap. Going to keep it, going around the right side, and he's tackled after a short gain, and the flag flies. Holding against the Hawks, that's going to move them back.
All we brought back to the 14-yard line.
So first and goal coming up from the 14. Loss of 10 on that penalty. See if Coulson puts it up or going to hand it off here. Hands it off to the motion man number two.
Touchdown!
Jalen Alexander makes it look easy. 14 yards around the right-hand side for the score. Goes in untouched. So 34-7 here, Hoffman Estates with the lead, pending the extra point attempt. The orange and blue Hoffman flags flying here on the sidelines. So the kick is up and it's good. A little bit of a high snap, but able to get it down and kick it through. So 35-7 with a minute 57 left to play. The Hawks looking awfully good here tonight, football fans. Looking strong going into Frem next week. We hope to bring you that game from Frem High School. On Hoffman Estates, looking awfully good. So there's the kick, it's away. Deep kick this time, and that's going through the end zone for a touchback. Schaumburg gonna take over first and 10 at their own 20 with a minute 57 left to play. So the crowd's starting to thin here at Hoffman Estates. The Hawks have this in the bag, 35-7. So Hoffman Estates definitely going to the postseason this year. They're going to be 6-2 after this game. Chance to go 7-2 next week at Frem. And off around the right side to number 7, it's Cameron Powell. So Powell in at QB here. Gonna clean it up, hands it off.
Tackled by 45, Evan Morris.
So some substitutes in, getting some experience here.
Kevin.
That was Kevin Presbycian on the carry. So 3rd and 2 coming up. So Powell puts up the pass, good for a first down. Complete out there. The number six to Deontay Arnold. So a completed pass for Cameron Powell. First and 10, clock continues to run under 40 seconds to play. Powell puts it up. Complete again. Oh, able to break some tackles. Number three, Kevin Presbycian again. Tackled out of bounds with 28.8 seconds. So the Schaumburg offense able to generate a couple first downs here. But too little, too late.
Big shout out to Blake.
Schaumburg's going to drop to 4-4, and Hoffman Estates going to go to 6-2. Putting it up over the head of everybody.
Jawad Sheikh, no good.
Jawad Sheikh cutting that off into the middle of the field. Looked like Powell expected him to continue straight down the field. So 23.7 seconds with the clock stopped on the incompletion. So Powell putting it up again down the sidelines, just out of the reach of the intended receiver. That's number 16, Justin Stebbins. So a lot of new names out there for the Saxons here to end the game. Get them a little bit of experience, might as well. Low snap again. Powell puts it up over the middle.
Pass is intended for
just behind
six.
Deontay Arnold. Catchable ball, but didn't pull it in. It was a little bit low and behind him. So 14.3 seconds left. So Powell waiting the snap, has it. Puts it up again, complete. Over the middle to number six, and he's taken down. That's Deontay Arnold. Clock stops as the chains move. 6.5 seconds left to play in the game. Powell looking fairly good here. Quarterback, clock's running. Last play of the game, Powell back. Puts it up down the sideline, and that's intercepted. Number 37. That's Cameron Kindred on the interception, and that's the last nail in the coffin of Schaumburg. The Hawks finishing it off strong, 35-7, and they advance to 6-2, and they'll go to Frem next week to take on the Vikings, and we hope to have that game here for you at the HETV Game of the Week. So for Rick Signorella on camera, I'm Bruce Anderson. Hey, hoping you enjoyed this week's game. Tune in again next week. Thanks for watching.